Welcome to another segment of Handy Andy on BPTV. Today what we're going to be talking about is what every homeowner should do in the fall time, and that's having their furnace checked by a professional. So we have our friends from Tutti Mechanical, Frank Iozzo, going to be stopping by, and he's going to go through the full process of what you need to do every fall before the heating season starts, because you don't want to have happen what happens to a lot of people. They get a phone call at Christmas Eve, midnight, you have no heat in the house, or you're in the middle of a big snowstorm or a heavy cold snap or something, and you have no heat in the house. It's one thing to live during the summer without an air conditioner, but it's impossible to live through a cold winter without heat. So what we want to do is go through the process, not just changing a furnace filter, which every person should be doing anyhow a couple times a year, probably at least four times a year, but we're going to go through the complete tune-up cycle of a furnace, from what to check, or if you have somebody check it, great. This way you may know just what it is that they're doing, because a lot of people who will have someone come in, they just let them alone and let them do their job, and you never really know what it is you're doing. So stay tuned, watch this segment, and learn just what it takes to check a furnace every fall. Thank you. Frank Iozzo is one of the lead service techs for Tutti Mechanical. Frank, welcome.
Good morning, guys. How are you?
Good. What can you tell us? Tell us a little bit about yourself and the company you work for.
I work for Tutti Mechanical Systems out of McKees Rocks. I'm a residential service technician, and I do residential service such as furnace maintenance, furnace repairs, air conditioning repairs, some plumbing, but it's mostly furnace and AC in the residential side.
Is the HVAC something you've done your whole life?
Not my whole life, but most of it. I'd say I probably have over 20 years experience. More like 25 years experience in both residential furnace and AC.
Okay. Tutti Mechanical, what can you tell us about Tutti? Why did you pick Tutti to work for?
I picked Tutti Mechanical 14 years ago. I was with another major company, and I wanted to work for Tutti Mechanical. I heard about Tutti Mechanical, the way they treat their employees. As far as Tutti Mechanical goes, I'm just a small part of Tutti Mechanical. We have a commercial business. Now, the commercial business takes care of all these larger rooftop units through downtown Pittsburgh, I mean, all over. We have a plumbing division that will do anywhere from commercial plumbing to residential plumbing, such as a water heater, a faucet, toilet repairs. We have electricians that also do anywhere from the commercial to the residential. We're starting to do more and more of the standby home generators now, all the way down to replacing a light fixture in your home. I don't know the exact number, but we're right around 120 to 130 employees.
Sounds like a decent-sized company. So what do you say? Time to get started?
Let's go. Yep.
All right.
Let's get rolling. What we're going to do here, this is a furnace with sealed burners. It's a 90% efficient furnace, which is a sealed burners.
Okay, while you're taking that off, can you tell me about the different efficiency? What makes a 80%, 90%, 95%? You know, what should a homeowner be looking at if they're looking at getting a new furnace?
Homeowners looking at getting a new furnace now, you want to stay within the 90% efficient. 90% efficient furnace uses outdoor air for combustion. That's why this is all sealed. It's not taking air from within the home. And it vents outside with the PVC tubing. So you have an intake and an exhaust that goes outside. And we can use the PVC tubing because a 90% efficient furnace burns all of your gas and your heat. So when it's leaving the home, it's not as hot as the older furnaces that had the metal flue pipe going up, which back then, 80% efficient furnace, if it's an old furnace now, we're at 75% efficient, 25 cents of your dollars going up the chimney, as opposed to 9 or 10 cents going up your chimney.
So purchasing a more efficient furnace, chances are you'll recoup your cost of the difference between an 80 and a 90% in a year or two?
That's correct. Yeah, that's correct. We've noticed that the difference in the customer's gas, the cost of gas has been sufficiently lower using a 90% efficient furnace. What I'm checking for in here, we've had a problem in the past years. This year hasn't been too bad. You'd be surprised the stink bugs we get in the furnace burners, and they've caused issues. And so checking that, I'm going to pull our intake pipe, which in your case is a little more difficult. I'm going to pull this intake pipe just to see if I have any debris inside, which could be leaves, sticks, twigs, pine needles, stink bugs. Alrighty, all is clear.
This. I have to admit, I never thought to check for stink bugs in a furnace. So
I never thought of it either until we had a real bad problem with them a couple years ago. This year I found a couple, but we've had furnaces that have been shut down due to stink bugs, and they get inside the burners and they block the flow of gas. It takes longer to get to a customer's home and clear it than it does to do anything else, and it's a nuisance. Alrighty, what we're going to do now is, this is relatively clean. Because it's a sealed burner, it stays pretty clean. What I'm going to do is I want to get inside here and clean the burners and any dust we may have in here. What I'm going to pull out now is called a flame sensor. Oh, by the way, safety first. What I'm going to do now...
That switch on the side that you just turned, that controls all
that
power
kills
going
everything
to the furnace.
That kills everything inside here.
So if somebody said all of a sudden their furnace quit working, that's something that they could actually check themselves?
They can actually check themselves.
That switch is on?
Pardon me?
They need to make sure that...
Oh, sure. We've had cases we've gone out, and there have been kids playing in a basement and have bumped it, or curiosity causes it to flip. Another thing here, a lot of customers don't even know it. You've got a fuse in here.
Okay.
Check that fuse. I've had over the years where it'll just vibrate. This screws in and out, similar to a light bulb. And I've, through vibration, we've had it where it's loose and just not making contact. And there's also a fuse there to protect it if there's any kind of issues. That fuse will blow, and you'll lose all power to it. This is called a flame sensor, and what we do here is we pull the flame sensor out and clean it. This doesn't look too bad. However, we come out, we clean it. What this does is recognizes that the gas burners have turned on and tells the furnace to continue to operate, very similar to a thermocouple in old furnaces and in years past. What happens here is, due to, believe it or not, there's dirt in our gas, what happens is this will get all carboned up, not able to make a signal to tell the circuit board to continue, and it shuts down. Once again, another nuisance call if you don't have a routine maintenance where we have to come out in the middle of the winter, which is inconvenient mainly for the customer, go out there 20 minutes, pull it, and clean it. So very important to clean this. Being that this furnace is a sealed furnace and doesn't pull any air from within the home, this furnace is relatively clean.
Now, I have to say that this furnace here is about 20 years old
now. I can tell you exactly. It's from the 33rd week of 94.
Okay. So there you are. And with that, this is what shows from. I know that we do have
this. This has been maintained.
This furnace is maintained once a year.
So. This furnace has been maintained.
But that's a reason we could get that life out of the furnace.
That's correct. That's exactly exactly right. Now what I'm noticing here, and it's a lot of visual too, what I'm noticing here, at one time, who knows when, not recently, we had a water leak from our drain trap, and I can see that it's been repaired here. So that was a leak at one time. No problem, no issue, it's cosmetic, there's no damage, nothing wrong with that. But what I'm going to do now is I want to check this trap to make sure that it's free flowing. And the way I do it, different people do it different ways. I find an easy way to do it. And what I do there, this is one of the drains that go into the trap. This is another drain here that goes into the trap. Pull these off. What happens over some time, these traps can clog up, very similar to a trap that's under your sink. You have they used to call them gooseneck, whatever, but anyhow, there's a trap under your sink that clogs. This is a trap also, and that can also clog. One easy way that I do it, just make sure it's free flowing. That one's fine. And all I did was blow through that trap to make sure that I was clear. And I'm satisfied that it's clear. I'm satisfied that I don't have any leaks here. Make sure this gets put back together. If not, you'll end up with water. This is something that the homeowner is really not familiar with. This is something that the homeowner really shouldn't do. You got to be careful with all this tubing. And everybody has a different degree of how far they can go. All right, that all looks fine. Now what I'm going to do is just go and do a general snugging. Every now and then you'll find something a little loose. Go over and do a general snugging of it. Everything in here looks just fine. I'm looking for any terminals that may be loose, any terminals that may be oxidized or rusted. This furnace has been taken care of. I want to continue with some cleaning. We got a little motor here. When this is running, this spins and it has a tendency to draw some dust and dirt in there. This is your main circuit board right through here, and this is the brains of the unit. Your thermostat comes down and goes into here and tells it what to do. That's the brains of this furnace. If there's any problem within the circuit board, they're not repairable, they need replaced, and that's something that should be done by a qualified technician.
This furnace being 20 years old, any more, is there life expectancies on a furnace, or you know what? Okay, this furnace looks like it's in decent shape, but in 20 years now, is it on borrowed time, or is it still doing well? Do we have another 10 years potential if it's taken care of? What do you think on expectancies on furnaces anymore?
Well, I think you do. When you get to a furnace that's probably, I'm going to say, and I tell all our customers, when you get around the 18, 20, 22 years old, if it's working fine, okay. If you start getting into some circuit board repairs that could take you into $400, inducer motor repairs that can take you around that number, gas valve could be costly. When you get into costly repairs, very similar to a car, don't do it. Any repair that I would do to this furnace, it's still a 20-year-old furnace. So that's when you want to decide. Do you want to put the money into it? There's a hot surface igniter in here that makes the burners turn on. That's a wear and tear item. If that goes, that's not reason to replace a furnace. But if we have a blower motor problem, circuit board problem, these pressure switch controls here, then you're going to get into some costly repairs, and that's when you want to say, is it worth putting it into it? How much more am I going to get out of it?
Okay, I don't want to put you on the spot,
go
but
ahead.
Of course I will.
Go ahead.
Say a circuit board, then you're saying that could be a $400 or $500 repair to replace this furnace. What do you think a cost to replace this furnace
to replace this furnace, you're probably going to be, this furnace, around the $3,000 number.
Okay.
It could
material
be 28, right, material labor. It could go from 28 to 3 to 31, but that's where you're at. So it depends on what you do.
All right. Well, also then going from a 20-year furnace to a brand-new furnace, is there efficiencies that we would see as a homeowner that it would help recoup the cost of spending $3,000?
Oh, correct. Oh, yeah. This happens to be a very good high-end filter, which is available through Andy, I believe. You sell these, Andy?
Absolutely. Sell a lot of furnace filters of all types.
What I like about this filter is it's a larger filter than your one-inch filters.
Now, why is that good?
Well, that's good because there's a lot more cleaning surface on here.
Now, before you pull that out, how about opening the new one and let's see the difference?
Oh, we'll see the difference.
Filter.
We're going to do that right now. We're going to show you just how dirty it is. Because the dirt comes in from the underside of this and goes, so the underside of this filter will be your dirtiest. This filter's doing a good job. When you see the dirt here, don't be alarmed. This is where you want to see it. If you pull your filter out and your filter's always clean, it's somewhere else. And you see the cleaning surface on these filters as opposed to the one-inch filters.
Right.
There's a larger cleaning surface here.
And that's what makes a pleated filter better?
I was just going to say that my recommendation, if your furnace, your duct work has the one-inch filter, use the pleated filter. The pleated filter has more cleaning surface on it, and it's a little tighter knit to trap some of the finer final particles of dirt.
So you trap more dirt with the pleated filter over a fiberglass type filter.
That's correct. And need I say any more? You could see the job that this did.
Right. Now on a filter like this Aprilware filter, how often should this filter be changed?
Usually once a year.
Okay.
But I'll tell you a little story about that, and the same as the filters that you see in your store. I know you see some filters that say last 3 months, last 6 months, last. That's just a reference. Everybody's traffic's different. Everybody's dirt is different. If you have several pets in your home, you're going to be changing it more often than the person that doesn't have it. These filters here are approximately 1 year.
Now, we actually change this twice a year. I like to change it once for the beginning of air conditioning.
Most cases, that's how we do it.
Right. Once for air conditioning and once for heating.
That's correct. What I'll do is I'll go out to a customer's home, and I go for air conditioning and for heat. And I've seen that the filters usually get changed twice a year. If I were to come out here today and I see that this filter is borderline, but you're going to need it in another month, I'd go ahead and change it. I'm here. You just change it.
Yeah, it keeps the house cleaner also.
No, that's correct, because it's trapping all your dust and dirt through here. Now to get this all put back together. This could be difficult for some people. Yeah. I do this all day long, and I don't have a problem with it.
So the more pleats or the deeper the filter, the more surface area, so the more dust that you trap,
that's correct. The deeper
the pleats.
That's correct. That igniter should, there it goes right now, our igniter. And which is, it's a glow coil. There's no pilots here, no open flame. Our gas should come on, and there goes our gas. are gas lit across, satisfied the flame sensor, and says, we have flame, continue operating. While it's doing that, I'm going to check some safety controls. And what I'm looking for is voltage. Once again, this is something homeowners usually don't have this kind of equipment or don't know where to look. Probe. Checking safety controls, reading my voltages on the in and out. There's a lot of safety controls on these furnaces, unlike the very old ones that don't have them. Now what I'm going to do, being that I've been burning for a little bit, I want to check for carbon monoxide. We're just going to do a CO run here to make sure I don't have anything leaking through here. And I don't want to see any carbon monoxide.
So you want to keep your Dow at zero?
I want it to stay at zero. And if there were carbon monoxide, this would have spiked. If there were a tad of carbon monoxide here, that wouldn't hurt you. I still don't like to see it. It wouldn't hurt you. Because you're not inside this compartment.
Right.
Do you know what I mean? The most important part is our airflow. You happen to have a register right handy here. So this is my main concern on CO, is in your airflow. Like I said, if I had very little here, a couple parts per million, that wouldn't excite me. But as long as I do not have it in the airflow. Just a visual on my burners. Nice, good, steady flow of burn. If my burners were fluttering, then I have other issues.
Do you look for different color flames?
Well, I look for different color flames at different points. Right now, I'm okay. But you'd be surprised, the dirt that's on your hands, you create
different color flames just
right
there.
That's right. Now if I get a good blue flame coming out of the burner, I'm okay. If I have a little yellow toward the back, just a few little flare-ups, nothing to worry about there. We've got some dust and some dirt in there, but I've got perfectly good blue flames.
So the importance of doing a furnace check like this once a year, it's not only extending the life of the furnace, but it's a safety issue to extend the life of the family, let's say, you know, trying to find if there's those safety issues or those carbon monoxide issues.
Correct.
Or so. And I don't think I can emphasize enough the importance of a yearly checkup.
Oh, that's correct. Like I said in the beginning, safety's first. Yeah, if you're comfortable, if it's working and you're comfortable, That's not the whole answer.
Right.
It's safety first. First we go with safety, and then we want to make sure that your furnace is working to the best of what you have.
Well, and you know, I like to say that I'm handy. I know how to do things. I know how to work with tools in my hands. And this furnace checkup that you're doing this year and you've done previous years, this is something that I still, with everything that I know of in the home improvement industry, I still have a professional come in once a year, well, actually twice a year, once for the air conditioning
AC
and once for the furnace on it. I mean, I have a piece of equipment. It's $3,000 piece of equipment to pay for the yearly service fee and so forth. I think it's money well spent.
It is. And the homeowner, most homeowners, and you're handy, I know what you're capable of doing. I don't know if you'd have been capable of doing what I did today.
Not to the extent you did, absolutely not. I don't have a carbon monoxide detector like you have to check those things.
And I'm sure that you may know how to operate a meter, mm-hmm. but operating it at the right point. Some customers don't even know what a meter is. The only thing that I can stress is have a yearly checkup,
right?
stay on top of your filters, because you don't need me, per se, after I do my checkup, to change your filters. You should be changing them a couple times. If you have the 1-inch filters, you should be changing them a couple times throughout the winter. And a carbon monoxide detector.
Tell me, not to put you on the spot again with, pricing and so forth, but an average furnace checkup, what is the cost of what you just did for the, and I know it probably changes from brand of furnace and age and everything else, but can you give us a ballpark of normal furnace checkup
should cost? I can give you a pretty exact figure. The best way to do it, and 99.9% of our customers are service plan customers.
Okay, and what's that
mean? And the service plan customer, if I were to come into your home and you're a new customer and I talk to you about the service plan, which I do, a service plan is $189.
Okay.
$189, I will do the routine maintenance on your furnace, just like I did for you. And then that service plan covers me coming back out in the spring to go over your air conditioner. So it's two trips for $189, which breaks down to $94.50. If you need anything else, such as a filter, it's discounted. Humidifier panel is discounted. If you, with a service plan, if you need our services after normal business hours, there's no overtime rates. You pay regular rates, no overtime rates, and all of your repairs are still at a discounted price. And we have technicians on call every day, every evening. We're a 24-hour service, be it evenings, weekends, holidays.
Last thing I really want to touch on, I want to brag about 2D Mechanical for just a minute. One of the many reasons I love your company is heat for the needy. Can you just give us a brief overview of what is Heat for the Needy?
Heat for the Needy is coming up, and it'll be in January. I don't have the exact date yet. It's usually around the middle of January. And in the past 14 years, we've installed between 10 to 15 furnaces per year. For the Heat for the Needy is a program for those that are down and out, elderly, can't afford it, people with illnesses. There's a lot of different stories of who deserves a furnace for Heat for the Needy. And the way that works is people are nominated. We were forwarded names, addresses, phone numbers of those that are down and out and deserve a furnace. And our team goes out, evaluates it, and puts a plan together, gets them the equipment, and we refer to it too as the one day miracle, because it's done in one day, and the whole company participates. When I say the whole company, it's the dispatcher, it's the secretaries, it's the controller, it's the CFO, it's the owner Bob Tutti, it's his wife Mary Lee, my wife's involved, my daughter's involved, and everybody goes out into the field. Does it. It's a great day. None of us get paid, but there's no problem getting a turnout. And we do it, and it's a wonderful day.
So it's 10 to 15 furnaces and Heat for the Needy. It's free.
That's correct.
And it does not. There is, the furnaces you're putting in do not cost those individuals, those families,
penny. It doesn't cost them a penny. It doesn't cost them
It's a great program.
Anything. It really is. And you feel good about doing it.
Okay. 2D Mechanical here in McKees Rocks. You service all over Southwest Pennsylvania.
We service Allegheny County.
How about a phone number, Frank?
Our phone number is 412-771-4100.
Fantastic. Appreciate your time.
Thank you.
Thanks for your checkup.
You're welcome.
I think you learned a lot. I know I learned a lot today. And like Frank said, I talk a lot. I ask a lot of questions. He taught me a good bit today, so I thoroughly enjoyed doing this segment. I hope you did too. See you again soon.